pleasant. Good morning to one and all listening to us here on Island T. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It is the 8th day. It's Eclipse Day of April 2024. Good morning to Journey, Miss Henry, Jamdown, Elder, Dennis over there in New York, Javon over there in New York, Mr. Hanley in New York. I had a listener approach me while I was at work on the airport, so Miss Nisbet Richards, good morning. Miss White, good morning. Michi, good morning. Chef, good morning. I'm trying to make sure I don't forget anybody. Mommy, good morning. Emil, good morning.
Yes,
I think I did a good job.
From challengers.
Yeah, I can't remember anyone else. So Azard, if you could remember some votes. Oh, yeah, Gawain, Burl.
Mm-hmm. We have Mr. Politics, Mr. Culture. We have
yes,
Jam
Princess
Down.
Of Melanin. Yeah, I said Jam Down
okay,
already.
We
I didn't
have,
say Mr. I said Journey.
Have? Journey. We have Africa.
Okay, I didn't say Africa.
Mm-hmm.
I said Miss Henry.
Yes. Mr. McMahon.
Oh, how could I forget Mr. McMahon wanting to give away?
How could you?
Share? I know.
What about
morning,
Rusty?
Fidel. Hey, Rusty. Good morning. How are you doing in Taiwan this morning, Rusty?
Yes. So yeah. We have so many people who are listening.
Oh, and I have to make honorary mention of Miss Marguerite Brisbane. She listens. So good morning, Miss
nice.
Brisbane.
Yes, 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 yes. Also want to make mention, you know, of Kay Menon as well. She listens as well. So
oh,
if she's
good morning, Miss Kay.
Yes. So, you know, and I want to say good morning to everybody.
Yeah,
who
everyone
listens.
Tuned
yes.
in. Yeah.
To my mother, to my father who listen. Blessed morning to you, everyone.
Good
you know.
Diana, so good morning. Good morning, Venicia.
So many people.
Yep.
And we say marvelous Monday to you. We hope that you had a fantastic weekend, a wonderful weekend. And we ask and pray, you know, that your day goes quite well, everyone, today. You know, there was some sad news over the weekend.
Oh, boy.
And we know that we lost members of our population. If I am not mistaken, this is a Loop article that says 16 hours ago. It says here, two dead, one injured following shootings on St. Kitts. And it says two men are dead, while another man is nursing injuries following separate shooting on St. Kitts and Nevis. It says in the first incident, 33-year-old Alex Harris was at the Bastia bus and ferry terminal shortly after 12 a.m. on April 7th when he was approached by an assailant who shot him. It says here police officers responded to reports of the shooting and found Harris sitting motionless in a chair. He was later pronounced dead at the scene. Almost 2 hours later, a masked man walked into the bar on Main Street in Parsons Village and began shooting. When the smoke cleared, 37-year-old Rashiel James was dead, while 30-year-old LeSean Hazel had a gunshot wound to his leg. Hazel was transported to the hospital for treatment. These latest acts of violence pushed St. Kitts and Nevis's 2024 murder toll to 8. Yeah, I remember hearing of the news, and then as soon as I heard of the news, then in the morning again I heard of another news, and I was like, is that person referring to the same murder? Right. And then I realized it had been two. Yes.
No,
we have to be very careful. It had been another. So they yeah. had been it had been two.
Two murders, yes. Which
and
is
so
sad.
I was like, wow. And I want to say condolences to all of the family members.
Yep.
You know?
The family members of the assailants, because mm-hmm. once caught, a next son is locked away and we lost two more. So I still don't get it how we're killing each other, especially the men, because you're never hearing a woman is involved unless it's in a crossfire. It's always the men that we're losing.
And I from the video, I saw someone post a video. So from the video, I know I recognize one of them, and the other one, 37-year-old Rashiel James, he's actually from Middle Island constituency number 4. So I know of him. And so I want to say condolences to the family of Mr. James. I want to say Condolences to the family of Mr. Harris and to Mr. Hazel's family. Hope a speedy recovery. Of course, we in no form or way condone violent acts like these. And of course, our federation has lost two members and one who is in critical condition. Well, let me say the person before they said nursing injuries. I don't want to put words that it's not. Based on the article, it said nursing injuries. So we have one who is nursing injuries.
Mm.
Yes.
Oh boy. And on the other side of things, don't mean to be the bearer of bad news today, but I see there is a water rationing schedule. Mm-hmm. So from yesterday, Sunday the 7th to Sunday the 14th, April 2024, from 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. daily. So it's from yesterday until the 14th. Water will be rationed in these areas: Bird Rock, Half Moon Bay, Olivies, Shadwell, Bastyr, Taylor's, Connery, Keys, Keon, Otley's, Lodge, Molyneux, Phillips's, Mansion, Tabernacle, Saddler's, Parsons Ground, Date Bay, St. Paul's, Newton Ground, Sandy Point, St. Peter's, New Road. So it's basically the whole island. So we just have to make sure we fill up. So you fill up by five, six. So at least when the water goes at 7, you have enough. And as I always say, I always have bottles filled up and stored in my cupboard just in case I just add bleach to them when necessary. So the water rationing will happen from 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. So for those of us that wake up at 5 and are ready to turn our pot, the water says it should be on by then. So waste not, want not. Conserve as much as you can, fill up as much as you can, because we know water is life, water is necessary. We need water for almost everything. We see when we have hurricanes and our water run out, how out of place we feel. So let's conserve to preserve.
Yes. Also, I want to say, you know, I had the opportunity to participate as a judge at the Washington Archibald High School's talented teen queen pageant.
Already?
The school had its pageant whereby they had a total of 5 girls from the school participating in pageantry for the title of the Miss Washington Archibald High School teen, you know. Of course, that would Miss Washington Archibald High School, the who would participate in the Miss St. Kitts and Nevis teen competition in December. So I want to say congratulations to all of the 5 young ladies who really put on an amazing job, amazing performance. I also want to say congratulations to the winners, you know. They were 3 top placements. We had Miss Tatum, who placed 2nd runner-up. We had Miss Rollins, who placed 1st runner-up, and we had the Queen, Miss Rogers, who placed, well, the Queen. Yeah, and how it was a really tight competition, because I will tell you this, even though the 2nd runner-up had not captured any of the judge segments, she was really in the competition nonetheless. And then they had the 1st runner-up, who had 3 of the 5 segments. And the winner won 2 of the 5 segments. At one point in time, you were wondering who is going to be the winner. Mm-hmm. And the winner edged out the 1st runner by just 5 points. Yes, so it was really a close competition. I think all of them would have been in the 600 point margin. So all of them was in 600 and very close. So I want to say congratulations. I also had the chance to judge for the Bassett High School, Mr. BHS as well. And I want to say kudos to those persons who have organized the pageant. Mm-hmm. You know, there was a winner, contestant number 3. I can't remember the name right now, but again, to the schools who are doing what they're doing, Bassett High School, the Washington Archibald High School, putting on these shows to, you know, equip and prepare themselves for December when time comes around. Kudos to the schools. I know that a lot of similar pageants are happening now in the schools. They're back on track. And so as time goes on, we'll see, I guess, more in preparation for the carnival.
You seem to have had a busy weekend. Saturday, I wasn't doing my best. And that heat on Saturday,
oh my gosh.
Yes. Thank God for AC.
It was grueling. It was boy. The heat, and you know there had been an advisory for the warm weather from Antigua. I saw an advisory.
And Grenada.
Yes, and I said if Antigua is an advisory, I think we too should have one. Because
someone told me there was one, but I didn't hear it.
Yes.
But I was like, no way. Even my friend in Antigua, she'd be like, "Caught, we here inside under the fan." Like, it
was extremely hot.
I
had headaches on Saturday and
Antigua
Sunday.
Had 50 degrees Celsius weather. That's 122 degrees Fahrenheit. Grenada's temperatures were 31.7 degrees for the 8th consecutive day. Mm-hmm. That's the temperature Grenada's been having. So imagine how Grenada has been feeling over there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy.
It's been extremely hot.
Yeah.
You know, the solar eclipse is to be today.
Yes.
April 8th, we have the solar eclipse.
But do you see how people are trying to scare us with this solar eclipse? It's the end of the world. Just like how they were saying in 2000, everything was going to shut down. And I swear every time some big event is about to happen, somebody's trying to scare us and showing us, oh, this is why we are having these earthquakes in Taiwan, in New York. Don't you see this is happening? Don't you see? Yeah, we see the droughts. We see all of these things happening. But I guess they have to happen. But why are you scaring people already? You can't scare people into things. Just let's just keep
so
a watchful eye.
It says that the states in the path of totality for the 2024 solar eclipse include Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Missouri, says Illinois, Kentucky, it says Michigan, sorry, it says Ohio, it says Pennsylvania, it says New York, Vermont, and it also says Maine and New Hampshire. So those are the states that are going to be really see the full show, you know. I think we are going to get some aspect of it here in St. Kitts. I know there was a specific time given. But we have to look back, maybe throughout the show we could find what time we could expect it to be. So it says, I'm looking here and it says partial eclipse in St. Kitts and Nevis. And it says around 2:56. It says here, and I'm going from timeanddate.com. It says total solar eclipse. It says local time, it says partial solar eclipse in St. Kitts and Nevis. It starts Monday, 8th April 2024 at 2:56 p.m. And it says not visible from St. Kitts and Nevis. It says not visible from St. Kitts and Nevis. It says end.
Not visible from
that's
him?
What he said here.
Oh,
he said end of partial Monday, April. It says the end of it will be 3:55.
Okay. So, we got that. We have that happening. So we're not really going to be seeing that. But what we're seeing,
Gems the door, Gems the why, Gems the why. You always trying to kill my hopes, and I just want.
He's just saying what it is.
What?
He's just saying what it is.
Huh?
I want to see the eclipse.
No, I'd like to see it too, but
then you know what you should have done.
I don't know. So we
go on to the stage.
Yes.
So we're not going to have any dusk-like conditions or anything. Dusk, as in like twilight.
I know. I understand. But
no. Well, moving right along. It's now time for me to have my.
Have your coffee.
No, my mini. What? My mini. Pam press conference.
Oh,
in which you will answer all the questions.
Oh, okay, go ahead.
Okay. So, you know, of course, after you guys had your press conference last week, someone, I don't know who, I'm not sure. By the way, did you guys commission a survey?
I don't know official body from our arm, at least I can recall in my knowledge. Commissioned a survey.
This is going well. Okay, he's answering the questions. Okay, so so as you know, there's been a poll that someone put up a poll on strawpoll.com, a survey.
I've seen it.
Asking who people would like for the Pam leader.
Yes,
and five candidates were put up, and the five candidates are Jonelle Powell, Carlene Henry Morton, Natasha Shani Gray, mm-hmm. Azard Gumbs. Mm-hmm. Who's that? That name sounds familiar.
Very Azard familiar.
Gumbs. I think you refer to him in here as AZ.
And Laverne Kane. So,
yes.
The poll was posted 2 days ago. So the question goes, who is the best choice to be next leader of the People's Action Movement? And you have Natasha Shani Gray with 72 votes. Mm-hmm. Carlene Henry Morton with 60 votes.
Oh,
that's going
Azard Gumbs with 39 votes.
He's in number, number three?
Yeah, and Jonelle Powell with 17 votes and Laverne Keynes with 3 votes. Oh, so yes. Your thoughts?
Well,
how many people did you pay off?
Well,
I'm just joking.
I know. I mean, I don't think anyone from our, especially from the executive, know of the poll that is happening or had expressly poll being done. Of course, you know, when it is that a political party is about to transition in terms of leadership, there are going to be persons who are going to be asking questions, and rightfully so. There are going to be persons who are looking at individuals perhaps who are, you know, in the limelight, persons who are more senior in the party and persons who they also think would have some sort of influence to make that position, to do well in that position. So I think what it shows that persons are interested in knowing what is next for the People's Action Movement. In fact, a lot of persons would have given criticisms as to the People's Action Movement, where it's going, how is it going to transition to ensure that it is ready and for the 2027 general election, because it's due then. We know it could always be before. It's really in the hands of the Prime Minister and other mechanisms that could be in place to force an election. But generally speaking, it is expected to be in 2027. So the party is doing what it has to do in terms of be ready. And of course, we see that since the announcement of our political leader, the Honorable Sean Richards, at last Thursday's press conference, he indicated that though he's going to still be a part and he's still political leader as it stands, he will not be contesting leadership as political leader in the next caucus and convention that is scheduled for this year. And so we expect, you know, persons to come forward. Of course, those names aren't limited. Persons can always come forward if they so have a desire to serve in the party. And so it's going to be, it's expected to be an open process. We realize that it could be something that is also sensitive too. And so how it's handled really has to be really well and very delicate. Yes.
Oh, okay. So I was just going to ask you, are you going to filibuster the question and answer the question for 10 minutes? Like Timo?
No, I was just giving you
Timo right? Should write a textbook on that, boy.
So I'll just sip some Timo.
How do you have a two-hour press conference and answer 3 questions? You ask a question that takes all of 20 seconds to ask, and you talk for 12 minutes, and at the end of it, what did I just hear? What did I just learn? Nothing.
I think I gave you a good amount of information. You. Okay, good. I'm just making sure.
Okay, so it's possible then that mm-hmm. he might mm-hmm. stay on as the representative for constituency 5.
Well, he would be best placed to answer that question at this point in time. Okay. He has not indicated that. He has indicated that he is still going to be much a part of the process, still a part of the party. Whether it's likely or not, it's left to be seen, but he is best suited to answer that question in terms of how he's going forward. This is his arena, this is his stage, and he has served the party well. He has been the political leader for a total of 12 years. He has been a member of parliament for a total of 20 years, and he has been the candidate that has not lost his seat ever since he has run.
Okay. All right. So it's 8:30. We're going to go take a break. We have traffic talk coming up next, brought to you by Caribbean Alliance Insurance. And that was my impromptu.
Very impromptu. I didn't know it was coming. Yes. I didn't know it was coming.
Yes. You handled yourself with a plum.
What's a plum?
A plum. Look it up in the meantime.
Okay. Thank you.
different. We're 98.9 WINN FM.
I'm begging you to. When it comes to the important things in life, your health, your education, your choice of a life partner, and of course your insurance provider, only the best will do. Caribbean Alliance Insurance is the only insurance company in the Eastern Caribbean with an A excellent rating. We have a robust three-tier reinsurance strategy that protects our policyholders from multiple catastrophes, even if they occur in quick succession. We spread our risks over 18 territories, ensuring minimal impact to individual territories when a disaster strikes. We provide an excellent claims experience. Claim settlement is usually between 24 to 48 hours. Our A excellent rating means that you are more secure with us. Contact us for motor, property, marine, public liability, employer's liability, and other policies. Delil Walwin, people you can trust. Local agent for Caribbean Alliance Insurance. Tomorrow secured.
Be careful on the road. Go make it an episode.
Well, it's the April 8th episode of Traffic Talk, brought to you by Caribbean Alliance Insurance. Good morning.
Good morning, Officer Sophie. How are you doing today?
Good morning. I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, what's on our plate today? What are we going to speak about? But before we start, I have to tell you something. You know those nice little mirrors that we use at the fire station and at the, I think it's the Washington Archibald School that helps us to come out on the road safely? Do you see what has happened to those?
Yes, we don't have any right now, so.
Oh, boy.
We'll have to come out at our own and take our time.
Okay.
Because before mirrors, we used to maneuver without them before.
Yeah, but
so we just have to
come
back
great.
With it. Yes, I know you have some road hogs, but still we have to take our time when we come out from intersections.
Okay.
We are out of them presently.
Okay. It's nice that you guys replaced the one at the top of Victoria Road.
I don't know who replaced it.
Oh, okay. No, I thought it was you guys. Okay.
I don't know if somebody donated it, but we're out of them.
Okay. Yes. But it just blows my mind that we have vandalistic people who just break these things.
Yeah, why would you jump up and hit something like that? It's not a hoop. It's crazy. Okay, Officer Sophie, sorry. I'm just concerned that I have to creep out now. Yes.
Well, this morning we're talking about road safety.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Road safety, a solid foundation in road safety begins with a thorough understanding of traffic rules and regulations. These laws are designed to maintain order and prevent accidents, ensuring that all road users can safely share the road. Like I was just talking about the mirrors.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. In everyday lives, road safety carries a lot of importance. It is important how we walk, drive, or do anything on the road. People define road in two ways. One, a busy road, and the other, not so busy. A busy road can be defined as the road where there's a lot of traffic going in and out every day. For instance, Keon Street, Fort Street. To avoid these, a driver should be careful not to break the road safety rules and maintain the road safety culture. A road is a road no matter if it has zero, some, or much traffic on a road. A road is a road no matter how busy it gets in the day or how lonely it gets at night. So, for instance, about somebody calling some time ago, say, okay, on Sundays, you know, the road is not so busy. Although we have traffic light, do I still have to follow the rules? Yes, we do. So he's saying, okay, because nothing is coming and I have red, I can proceed. No. Whether it's lonely or it's busy, we have to follow the rules.
Whether it's lonely or it's busy.
Road safety refers to the measures which must be adopted by everyone while using the road. Mm-hmm. These safety methods are meant for reducing the risk of accident and injuries or casualties on a road. As I said before, these rules must be followed by all road users. And this includes pedestrian, cyclists, motorists, and bus and truck drivers. So if you're a pedestrian, you follow the rules that are pertaining to pedestrians. Many factors influence the road safety. The most important factors are drivers' behavior. Sometimes when someone drives on the road, it can factors whatever is going on. If you drive with caution, you know everything going to be safe. Mm-hmm. If you drive like the road belongs to you alone, you know what's going to happen.
Problems.
Mm-hmm. And all, once you're using the road, once you're behind that steering wheel, make sure you have on your seat belt. Even the passenger who is on the side of you, make sure that passenger is have on. That passenger has on this seat belt. Because if, for instance, the police have to stop you, it's not the passenger going to have to pay the bill. You're the one who have to pay that
ticket.
But
what if your passenger had and then don't want to put on the belt and you tell
then
the police?
Then you put them out.
You put them out. Okay. You say, well, you ain't want to wear this
seatbelt. Yes, you don't want to follow the rules.
Put them out. Mm. Okay.
Can you get out of my vehicle?
That's it.
Yes.
Okay.
And if you're on the 14 or over 5 and you're in the back or the front, you must be restrained by a seatbelt.
Can a five-year-old sit in the front of a vehicle since you're on that topic?
It doesn't matter where they sit, but once they're wherever, because they're over the age of 5, so they do not need a car seat.
Okay.
They must have on a seatbelt. The rules, the regulation didn't say where.
Mm. No, but a five-year-old.
It is you if you want to put that five, because remember the belt is not going to be so good to restrain that child, especially if they're small.
Okay.
Remember we have some small here. Yeah. Some
small
five-year-olds.
Yes. Okay. No problem.
And sometimes factors of road safety can contribute from construction and condition of roads. Even the vehicle maintenance. So control your maintenance of vehicles, that can be a factor. The construction of road, we know. That can be a factor. Thank God they are fixing the holes. Yes, they are. Up to Friday, I pass on Cairn Street and they cut out some, and up to Saturday, they were fixed.
Still in them. Okay.
Yes, I see on Victoria Road, they have the paint around the holes. So they're doing it.
There's a nice hole there at the fire station that is going to become a problem soon. Where's my voice going? It's going to become a problem soon because it's coming out. So for the powers be that are listening, please. I know I have a problem with the mirror. Now I have a problem with the little hole that's going to be big soon.
Roads are essential in everyday life. We all use them in some way, by driving, walking, or traveling as a passenger. And we depend on them to obtain good services. Yes, as we were just talking about the holes. Yes. Because if you're coming up and you see a hole, you're going to dodge off that hole.
Yep.
And sometimes when rain falls, and you know there's a puddle, you don't know what is in the road. Drive safely, because if you drive and you wet up someone, that's an offense. That is driving without consideration for other road users. You can be summoned for that. So sometimes if you see water, you don't know if it's a hole there. Or even if it's not a hole, you do not just drive through it. Mm-hmm. You take your time and go through it. I don't know if you have any calls yet.
Callers, you are invited to call in. This is your opportunity. This is your moment. We are here in Traffic Talk. I know there are a lot of issues surrounding road safety in terms of the road condition. You know, of course, we welcome you to speak about any matters, any matter that concern you and concern those.
Okay. I have some notices here. Not notices, messages here for you. Don't worry, notices came from. I have someone to, really mad about the vendors seeming to return to the street. Okay. First, let me read. The fact that... let me see. Where is that? Now, he was talking about the pork man who tends to... who usually is in front of what used to be the Amina Market on Liverpool Road. And, you know, he's on the sidewalk. He's on the sidewalk and in the road. And my friend is saying the fact that he's advertising full lunch means he has relocated there permanently. Vendors are not paying wheel tax, so they don't need to be robbing wheel tax payers, drivers, of course, the chance to use the carriageways for the purpose it was intended. With this free movement of people, I anticipate the problem to get progressively worse. If non-nationals are allowed to do as they wish, then the locals will surely do the same. I spoke to Deputy Commissioner of Police, Cromwell Henry, earlier this afternoon. He spoke to him at some point about this vendor relocating to this position. Now, he has also said that he's noticed that the vendors are coming back out onto the sidewalks, you know, hindering pedestrians. And in the case of the pork man on Liverpool, or actually taking up parking space. So, comments?
Well, I cannot comment on that. As he said, he spoke to the deputy. I'll have to get on to him.
Oh, yeah. He also related an incident. He said he parked on 4th Street for 31 minutes, and they gave him a ticket. And he feels that the police should be concentrating. Rather than going for the low-hanging fruit, they should be really going after the really egregious things, because he thought it was unreasonable that he parked it's 30 minutes, you park for 31 minutes, and he gets a ticket. And I totally get that.
Well, as I will always say, some persons have different, my conscience might be the same as somebody else. If I said I might be lenient, which I cannot speak of that person, I don't know. He might say 31, but maybe the length of time that the person saw the vehicle here, it could have been more than 30, I'm not sure. But I cannot speak of that. I want to speak of mine. If I see something like that, what I will do. As I said, with the Liverpool war, I can get in touch with the deputy and find out.
But what's the policy on actual vendors?
I don't know. I don't know if something went back. I know everybody was supposed to be in the market itself, the public market.
Because I have noticed that vendors seem to be coming back out in force.
I can find out, and next show I can speak on that.
Okay, so you don't know what the policy is from a legal standpoint. Mm. Okay.
Because I was just also, excuse me, I don't know what's going on my voice. If it is that if they're going to use the sidewalk but not protrude into the road, because the road
Sidewalk is bad enough.
Yeah, because you're forcing pedestrians to go into the road with the vehicles. Okay.
But we don't have any calls at the moment, so callers, feel free to call and weigh in on Traffic Talk. Traffic Talk is brought to you by Caribbean Alliance Insurance. It's 8:44.
Man behind the wheel plays an important role in most of the crashes. In most of the cases, crashes occur either due to carelessness or due to lack of road safety. Awareness of the road users, hence road safety education, is an essential and as any other basic skill of survival. So remember, you're the one who behind the steering wheel. So it plays an important role. You play an important role behind that wheel.
Yes.
And my aim today is to provide road safety information for road users to encourage road safety, road users' behavior among current and prospective road users, and reduce the number of people killed and injured on a road every year. Yes. I can't tell you use the road. You know what's going to happen. As I say, when you're driving, make sure you have at least a car or two car lengths behind the driver that is in front of you. For if that...
Caller, go ahead. You're live on Traffic Talk. Good morning. Good morning. Could you turn your radio down a bit, please?
I will listen to the radio. Good morning, Mr. Henry. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. We are good.
Yeah, I saw the lady there. Yeah, you know what happened to Miss Henry? When one say yes, some another one say no. The girl in the world will clean up the other day when Mr. Timothy in, you know. You hear? And because this government get in, they ain't walking down the road. I don't know why the people just get things get loose like that. They ain't out there walking, they just drive it. Minister of government, women and men and women, they're driving. And it's not right when you're coming down the road all the way up there by 4th Street, big umbrella, and not a dig in your eye. And you got to drop off in a drain. We ain't accustomed to this, you know. And it ain't right and not. Stone all come right out in the road now. Right there in the circus. Well, what country this? Everything just gone topsy-turvy from morning. And this sudden noise again in buses, Miss Henry, and cycle. You know me young no more, anybody come up me and expect a boop. And I go fly me heart, make me get heart attack. I get me heart sick, what's going on in this country? Mr. President, you need to come back alive when I call so much people they know than before, said in government service. What happened to them people who they said they had voices and so? You're just taking out with tax money a month time and 10,000, this thousand and nothing, I do. Nobody has sit down in a corner anyway. The little few gonna do it. Or you know, like the government, you know, like, who don't like what government? You're talking for your right. I beg you get the country straight, do you? Because nothing going good. What happened to them board around there, down there by social, by the old treasury? They look so, we in a different world. Why am the one up there by government at quarter? We never had no country say anything on nice pretty paper to make it. Mr. You have a good day. I beg I clean up your country. Country ain't going good tall. Them noise all over the night with them cycle and buses and talking. Got them kind of loud music with the careless song them in them. Mr. Muggy, you have a good day here. Yeah? Happy Monday. Think it's gone.
We have another call. Caller, go right ahead. All right, go ahead, caller.
Caller?
Yeah, I'd like to make a comment to the police officer. I mean, no disrespect whatsoever, but I think your topic on safety is misplaced for today. Since the host asked you up front what happened to the mirrors on the road, and if there's no mirrors, then there is no real safety. Because if I'm judging to come out and I get an accident, is it my fault? Is it the police's fault? There's so many things that are wrong. I'm a critic of the traffic police department because there's so many things that are wrong. If I'm coming down Victoria Road, the light that turns green tells me to go straight down to Victoria Road. There, that light should not be a green block. It should be an arrow going left and an arrow going right. People, it's like nobody know what traffic is supposed to be about or how traffic is supposed to run. There's a stop. If you pave the road, do you pay it back the stop immediately? No, that has never done in my lifetime. I don't know if it's happening now. I'm out of sync now, almost 5 years, so I don't know if that's the case. But the traffic department, if you want to keep safety on the road, you have to ensure that the roads are properly marked, properly operated. You just said if somebody driving a hole and they wet up somebody, you could be charged for that. Well, I'd like to say that happened to me. I drive across Pond Road and there are holes, potholes there. I can't go anywhere. I can't stop because cars behind me. And I go in the pool of water and splash up. I don't know if anybody get wet or not, but if you're now saying that's against me, the driver, how can I stop in time for a pothole? Potholes, when I was driving back home, there are potholes all over the place. I can't stay off a pothole and go into somebody's lane. It's ridiculous. So the police need to have a budget. And so they need to have enough money to change lights, to paint roads, or whatever. That is my concern. Other than that, we can't seriously talk or punish people for traffic. The other thing is that I was just told that there are a lot of these yellow lines that are being painted all over the island are not legal. So if you're parking on a yellow line and somebody gets a ticket, go to the court.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, caller. Remember, the speed limit in built-up areas is 20 miles. If you're driving within 20 miles and you see a pool of water, You're going to still go through it in a speed? No. You must be able to drive slowly, whether it's a pothole, yes or no, not to wet up someone.
You have a caller?
Caller, go ahead. You're live on Traffic Talk. Good morning.
Good morning to Traffic Talk.
Good morning.
I just want to compliment Bonus for speaking out about our call, because I speak about the boat them down at the old, by the old treasury and also up by Church Street in front of government headquarters. What are they going to do with those boats? They're going to keep them up as somebody just wants to say, well, oh, work is going on and there's no work going on? The traffic is tied up. That's why we have to start talking about traffic and you all don't come out to see what's going on. Because every morning I stand on my veranda and I can see the amount of vehicles coming across Fort Thomas Road, and nobody at all coming to make sure that Fort Thomas Road is looked after. We have up cameras and nobody is checking the cameras them to see who's speeding from who not speeding. You catch the thief them from off the cameras, because I see Mr. Askerson. I spoke about it. He told me when he was a minister in government, he used to call him and tell him, we can make some money by putting up those cameras. You don't have to go out and you back check the cameras them and you bring them in and you pay a fine. That is how we can make money. But if you are going to put up cameras and they are not using, what it says, it don't make sense putting up cameras. You all have a good day.
Thank you, Carla.
Thank you.
Okay, we have another caller. Caller, go right ahead.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
Those potholes in the road, they are a real nuisance. I mean, and it's becoming more so. The public works seem to have had a new method of fixing the road, which admittedly is superior to the old method. Okay? But the thing is, while that method takes up a lot more time, okay, it requires more equipment, etc. In the meantime, I think they should do the old method of just putting the asphalt, the mix, inside the holes as a temporary fix. Because, I mean, it's crazy to have potholes. I mean, that become craters, okay? So they should do a two-pronged approach. Yes, fix it with that new improved method. But in the meantime, there are some really vicious potholes all around the place that absolutely need to be temporarily patched, okay? And what needs to be done too? I know it's a general maintenance problem. The striping in the roads need to be maintained. You can't let the like, whether it's white or yellow or whatever, you can't let them just fade and leave it like that. They become safety hazards when you don't maintain them, okay? And that it at least makes the place look. Better managed when you have the stripings and signs and so on, properly maintained. Okay, so let's hope we have some improvement there. I mean, I don't think it's an exorbitant cost. It just requires some attention and somebody paying attention and making sure that the works involved get done. Okay, all right then.
Thank you, Carla.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. It's 6 minutes until 9 o'clock. If anyone has any calls, hey, feel free to call. Sophie?
Yes, as I was saying before, yes, I talk about driving the speed limit. And also, before the mirrors were put there, we always had the junctions. The junctions were always there. We used to come out and drive slowly to come out from junction. So whether a mirror is there, yes or no, we know what we should do when we're coming out onto a major road. It's not just bore out. And if you get in an accident coming out of a stop, as you say, is it you or the police? You will be charged, sir. Because remember, you're coming from a stop into a major road. So you come out, you take your time, and you come out. Make sure it is clear when you are coming out.
Mm-hmm. And another thing, the caller that called, I think the gentleman said her name is Bernice.
Yes.
The scooter guys, they're ridiculous. I was driving the other day, and one just flew from behind me. I didn't even see him coming. And just flew from behind me and ended up in front. And how is he riding the scooter without a helmet, one knee on the seat and one knee on the his pedals? Now, if he had an accident, what would have happened to him? Caller, go ahead. You're live on Traffic Talk.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
I think it last week, Thursday, there was the Agri Night Market, and there was cars parked on the seaside, and a relevant police officer was giving issuing ticket. I think you all should have put up some sign saying, do not park on the sidewalk. I was telling drivers, police out there issuing ticket, no park up there. So going forward, you all know you're going to have a night market. Put some marking ahead of time so the drivers know that they're not allowed to park on the sidewalk. And where I'm living at Pickup Here Alley, officer, I think there should be a sign, no entry, going up. You only could come down. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Thank you. Top part of Pickup Here Alley. Yes. And you spoke about
coming up.
Parking. Remember you have low and top.
Mm-hmm.
You can come from Fort Thomas Road into Pickup Valley. You could come from Central Street into Pickup Valley. I think it's the top one. Yes, but persons should not park on sidewall. It is not. It is illegal to park on a sidewall, because if you park on a sidewall, you're forcing the pedestrian down in the street.
Call, go right ahead.
Yes, good morning, officer.
Good morning.
I am concerned about the amount of people who don't dim their lights at night. And I'm wondering if when they are learning, if don't nobody takes them out in the night before they get a license.
I wouldn't be able to answer that. I can find out from the instructors, ma'am. But I wouldn't be able to answer that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's a good... A good one, because I mean, I got my license in 2008.
Yeah,
I can't recall if I was taken to drive in the night.
That's a good practice.
Yeah,
so that people, but the courtesy should extend, because once you learn how to drive, but people aren't courteous anymore on the road. The road is crazy.
Yeah, sometimes people come to you head on and they have their headlights on, and it's blinding. Sometimes you have to flash the light
to get them
to
turn it off.
Call. Go right ahead.
Caller, you're live.
Yes, that's a big problem again, you know. I don't live in Buckley's no, the other night. I got to park up in the bright light. Me, I ain't young, and I keep on no more. I couldn't even maybe be his grandmother or not. But I'm just thinking it's getting me while I'm crying. You know me, you know me. That's in my country, come like this alone. We ain't get it no real. Don't care what you put in. You get worse from worse. We got to do it. We handsome and another lady. So you kind of dim your park up the bullets. Get somebody. I mean, waiting for somebody. Dim your light. And everybody gone crazy, especially the younger one who's 20, 25, and 30. Because we ain't got no love for them. We drop all off. Miss Sophia, sorry to say you're working for a couple years now. I beg you, make your resign in the hotel company. There ain't no law there. No law. There ain't got no law for you. They lag on dead down the drain. Yeah, and just as the woman said a while ago, so me in a vehicle the other day, you know, the boy person come swing out. Swing from behind the person, Lord, Father Jesus, want to sing kids, everybody, mostly everybody gone crazy, especially the young one, them. My stomach, you see, I mean, never think me to live. I mean, you know, me don't live to see things come like this, me to go away, you know. Cause me could have get green card, yellow card, pink card, me stay here to enjoy my country. Me was in St. Martin, me come back from many ages, and this is why I say St. Martin, my law.
Okay.
Love for immigration, love for this, love for that. We ain't got none. We just come in on a boat and walk off the sun and say, oh, this is sink, it's I love you. Oh, my God, you top shit up, Miss Henry. You have a...
Oh, sorry about that. Caller, go right ahead. You're the final caller. Please be brief.
Yeah, good morning. Quickly, the sergeant is, puzzling me, because it seems as if she's defending the police in ticketing people on the Bay Road who park on the sidewalk, but there's a different policy for vendors. she would have to find out from the deputy commissioner. If you're blocking the sidewalk, you're blocking the sidewalk. Enforce the law. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. I said I don't know if something was put back in place with the vendors. So I said I'll have to find out. But I know for sure, and I know it's a fact, that persons should not park on sidewall. I know a couple of years ago they took the vendors off the road, but I don't know if something came back to say that they can go. Mm-hmm. So I'm not really defending anyone, sir. I'm just letting you know what I know. And the one who spoke about coming down Victoria Road and the light is solid green, we know that you cannot, fortunately, it's only a one way, you drive from south to north. And there's a sign said no entry. So if you come down and the light is solid green, you cannot go straight down because there are signs there that say no entry.
Okay. I'm getting a lot of calls. So I'll make this the last call. Go ahead, caller.
Good morning.
Officer, I don't know if this has something to do with you. But you know, the old treasury fence around.
Yes, sir.
Right as soon as you come out of the post office, now you try to hug close to the board because you know the vehicles as they're coming very close to you as the light change. So you'll try to hug as close to the board as possible. If you check, right as soon as you come around, there's a all hydrant there, right? Nothing there to protect walkers. The other day I come around, well, my eyes are in 100, my head on my glasses, and drop right in the hole there, the old drain there, drop in. You know, I clean forget. I mean, I'm at the back, I never expect it to be far so far out. So I hug as close as possible to the board. And I drop in, I was surprised. So if you could get somebody check it out for me, I sure tell me one drop in it. I sure others. So if a board could go over it, they could walk on the board, it will be all right. Right as soon as you come out the door from the
post office,
the west side of the post office, and you come out and you go up, if you look down, you see the hole right there. It's very dangerous. And the next thing again, I want to say this. Now, they put down a sidewall going up Bird Rock. They're going up the industrial site there. And I don't know if you noticed, you know, it is not for walkers. It is for parking. Because you go up there all right now, up there full of vehicles parking right up to the top. And I mean, if it is there for walkers, why they should park on it? Because the car is so wide that you take up the whole sidewall, and so you still have to walk in the road. So I don't see the sense the sidewall down there then. I will have to put it for parkers. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Continue doing a wonderful job.
Thank you, Carlo. I'll check out the hydrant, and I also check out at industrial site that you spoke of.
Okay, so it's 9:04, so give you the last word, Sophie.
Traffic signals are the silent conductors of the road safety. Understanding and obeying them contribute to smooth traffic flow and prevent chaotic situations that can lead to accidents. So when you're driving, make sure, remember to be cautious and be courteous at all times. Remember, the life you save might be your very own. Thank you all for listening.
Okay, right. And thank you.
Thank you, Officer Sophie.
Thank you.
When it comes to the important things in life, your health, your education, your choice of a life partner, and of course your insurance provider, Only the best will do. Caribbean Alliance Insurance is the only insurance company in the Eastern Caribbean with an A excellent rating. We have a robust three-tier reinsurance strategy that protects our policyholders from multiple catastrophes, even if they occur in quick succession. We spread our risks over 18 territories, ensuring minimal impact to individual territories when a disaster strikes. We provide an excellent claims experience. Claim settlement is usually between 24 to 48 hours. Our A excellent rating means that you are more secure with us. Contact us for motor, property, marine, public liability, employer's liability, and other policies. Delil Walwin, people you can trust. Local agent for Caribbean Alliance Insurance. Tomorrow secured.
We're different. We're 98.9. WINN FM.
Maybe it's the way the brilliant gold liquid reflects our sunshine, or how the bright blue of its label mirrors the clear Caribbean skies overhead. Maybe it's the fresh, crisp taste of this beastly cold beer on a scorching hot day. Maybe it's even the way it brings us all together. But one thing is for sure, Carib is very much a part of who we are wherever we're from in the Caribbean. Carib. It's the way we play. Drink responsibly.
Here are your Horse Value Mart IGA specials.
Running April 4th to April 17th.
Now our Value Club Blue Tag specials. Essential everyday canned vegetables, just $3.99. Mule's pasta, $5.99. Essential everyday single sliced cheese, $8.99. Banquet chicken tenders and nuggets, $25.99. Essential everyday ground coffee, $27.99. Essential everyday freezer bag, just $8.99. And now, our very low weekly
value deals. General Mills cereals, cinnamon toast, Lucky Charms, Cocoa Puff, $13.99. Ocean Spray cranberry drinks, $12.99. Ragu pasta sauce, $11.99. All Orchard 100% apple juice, $9.99. Northside dishes, $7.99. Equaline mouthwash, $10.99. Shop smart, shop value mart. Tell them in Spanish.
Sea listo y haga sus compras aquí en
Value Mart.
Are you ready to embark on the ultimate quest for business success? Join Revive to Thrive, MSME Makeovers TV show, presented by the Ministry of Small Business and Entrepreneurship. Discover how we plan to transform businesses like yours from surviving to thriving. For quest details, call us at 467-1203 or email at sbdc@gov.kn. Don't wait, the quest sign-up expires on April 11th. Press start and join us on the journey to take your business to the next level. Revive to Thrive! MSME Makeovers, transforming potential into prosperity.
Eight minutes after 9 o'clock, we're back here on Island T, and 8 minutes after 9 o'clock on April 8th.
Yeah, what coincidence.
Little numerology there. Stupid, but still numerology. Yeah.
Yes, and I know you say you're going to touch the solar eclipse for the voices. So, I mean, we could just... All I want to say is that it just seems so low-key. Like, I remember when I was a smaller child, younger, yes. It was a big thing. You had schools ready to look at this thing and everything. Everybody's warning you not to look.
It's not coming our way.
Warning you not to look up. But again, I'm not going to be looking up at any sun during that time.
Yes.
You understand?
Listen, the precautions we take when we are old in life, I sure as a kid we still try to look up without it quick and put it back on. As we get older, we be extremely cautious.
When we had them shades, where they said that they're going to protect our eyes, I said to myself, I just squint while watching very briefly. I made sure I double checked. So
you
I
knew
see that
you
a
needed
bit.
Your eyes.
Yes, yes. Precious, precious sight.
Oh,
yes.
Boy.
So, and I think what is the dangers associated with having your eyes looking at the eclipse without any protective
eyewear. Even looking at the sun without protective eyewear is problems.
So imagine. So, you know, I am just wondering about children, and are they going to be you know, just to make sure that they are prepared. We don't know.
But as Jamsa said, we're not getting a lot of it. So hopefully the teachers are warning the children not to look up.
Because I'm seeing that we're not getting some of it. And then I'm seeing something that's circulating saying that...
They're hurting my feelings, you know, but I give up.
That this is being circulated on Monday, 8th, April 2024. A partial solar eclipse should be visible to the Caribbean islands, while the U.S., Canada, and Mexico will be experiencing totality, meaning that the daylight will turn completely dark for some time. Please note that you should not look directly at the sun during the eclipse without specific eyewear, as the phenomenon can cause permanent blindness and other irreparable damage.
To the eyes.
Please be guided accordingly. Warn your children, as I know they can be very curious. And then he said, I am expecting NEMA to send out something, but expectation versus reality. That's what he thinks.
Yeah, to be honest, yeah, I really think NEMA could be a little more on the ball with some of these, you know, these, I guess, drills and public awareness and so on, yeah. Public awareness campaigns and so on. Mm-hmm. Because I remember last year when we had the Carib wave thing,
mm-hmm.
everybody, well, I got a text on my, well, I don't know if, I, okay, it's possible I got a text because I work at WINNFM and, mm-hmm. you know, I'm on the list.
But I think they have, but you had to put your name to some number of broadcasts.
Okay.
Something like that. Or maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, but. I just think. Oh, and I also did not know where the gathering area was for a possible tsunami. Someone told me. I never heard that from NEMA. They told me it's the area, you know, that mm-hmm. you know, the fenced area there by the airport. Yes. That big area that they fenced off around the lights.
Mm-hmm.
They said that's the gathering area. I never knew that. I think NEMA can do a better job of letting us know. Of, you know, spelling out everything in a relatable, step-by-step, even paint-by-numbers type way. So mm-hmm. people know exactly what it is they're supposed to do. Mm-hmm. You know? I mean, we had the Caribbean wave thing. No one ever told us. Well, suppose, if there's a tsunami, this is where you proceed to. I didn't know. It's someone who just happened to tell me along the way that this is where you go. I say, oh, really? I didn't know that.
So on this thing that says time and date, it says 5 hours, 43 minutes, 13 seconds, now 11 seconds, 10 seconds until the eclipse. And mm-hmm. it says partial solar eclipse, but it says here start of totality not visible from St. Kitts. So it says start of totality not visible from St. Kitts, end of totality not visible from St. Kitts. So this seems to be suggesting that the totality will not be visible from St. Kitts,
yeah.
but there's a partial solar eclipse.
But they could have used this opportunity to mm-hmm. tell people, listen, I don't even know, and I'm sure that mm-hmm. would be the same for you guys. I don't even know if it is that, even because we're not in the path of totality, does that mean we can or can't look at the sun? Someone should.
I'm not looking at the sun.
Neither am I. Neither am I. But you know what I mean. But you know what I mean, right?
I would just look out to see if it's darker. You know, during the time, but I'm not looking up.
I can't believe Azard is moving so scared though.
No. We have to be very cautious. You know, I think sight is very precious.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not just being cautious. Mm-hmm. I like to see things. Mm-hmm. You understand?
Call. Go right ahead.
Yeah. Good morning, Island P.
Good morning, Jamdown.
Jamstock.
Yeah.
From since the government changed information. It's hidden, you know, from people. You know, it's, you know, a lot of things of public interest. You can't get information, and even the country media, now, all of the eclipse thing, we should have hearing something from NEMA, it's true. But me, what? In this government organization, no. Unless a minister don't give the ultimatum, they cannot do it. Otherwise, they think them like they're politicians, like they support the political party. What is who in charge of the operation? Go ahead and do the right thing. But let's fight them. And this is where we got a total breakdown in the country. Look at the nastiness around back here. Have a good day, you know? Then I know more with that. Because okay. I know how we don't go.
Thank you, Jamdong. So, Yeah. So I guess, you know, you guys be careful. And Jamsa say he's going to go into it, so I don't want to really be go too much. So voices, if you're listening to voices, it's going to be a discussion on voices. So
also, speaking of voices, mm-hmm. I'm going to play that mm-hmm. interview that Sean Richards did with the the Carib Update people.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
In Grenada.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That'd be good. That'd be good.
So.
So, you know, looking at some news in the region, it says sentencing date for the former BVI premier pushed back. So it says the sentencing date for convicted former premier of the British Virgin Islands, Mr. Foy, Andrew Foy, has been pushed back following a request from his attorney due to a conflict with a paid vacation she had already booked.
Talk about affluenza. Mm. So you know what affluenza is, right? Imagine you're supposed to be going to jail, but you're gonna appeal on the grounds that, oh, I paid for this vacation. And
That's what the attorney is saying.
Is the attorney for the vacation, not him.
Well, that's same thing. I mean,
so she has to go on her vacation before her clients get sentenced. For her.
Ridiculous.
I mean, realistically speaking, right, as an attorney. Practicing attorney in private practice, these things happen, you know, because you have a situation where you plan certain things and then you have court dates being given. But for this, if that was the case and she had already booked it, then she could have indicated that the court when the matter was being heard, unless it was. But I don't want to speculate. It happens, you know. The situations are so. Let's see.
Yeah.
But on Thursday, she in asking a Miami court for a later. Okay, so she's asking for a later date. So it's not just that.
Okay.
So she said on Thursday.
She's probably gonna get a call from Donald Trump.
Miami for a later.
Great delay tactics.
Sentencing date also cited for the need for more time to finalize potential objections to pre-sentencing report. And requested that the date be moved from April 29th to a date later in June.
But
29th is my birthday. Oh, wow.
Oh, Lord. Here we go. here we go with the Azard numerology now. Anyway.
So
Azard, seriously though, you don't think that she, let's face it, she's probably using that as a way to help the client.
Keep out of jail.
Come on. She is.
But I mean, she said that she paid for her vacation already. Chances that she probably did.
Yeah, she probably did. But I mean, I'm sure she's using the chance to keep him out of jail for as long as possible.
But you notice both of the accomplices for that crime. Only the young man has been sentenced, you know, and serving his time already, you know. But you notice the bigger heads, the former director of the port, and him. There, it's constantly being pushed back. It's like it's just a ploy to keep them out of prison longer.
So based on her request, this is the request from the attorney. Judge Williams granted the motion and agreed to reset the sentencing hearing for June 25th.
And then when June 25th comes, there'll be
something else again. So he says here,
he's probably gonna pray for a hurricane or something.
Oh,
Foy was convicted on charges of conspiring. To import cocaine and related money laundering and racketeering charges after his trial concluded on February 8th in an unanimous guilty verdict. Foy was held with Maynard, the former managing director of the BVI Ports Authority in Miami, after the two conspired with Maynard's son. So it says a trio agreed to allow large amounts of cocaine to pass through BVI's ports as part of a multi-million dollar deal the trio made with an informant of the U.S. Drug Enforcement Administration who was posing as a drug trafficker at the time.
Yep.
The sentencing for Maynard has been postponed, but for different reasons.
What are the reasons?
Maynard admitted guilt over her role in the plot and agreed to testify against Foy in exchange for a lighter punishment. Maynard's son, Kadeem, was sentenced on November 20th, 2023 to serve
57 months in prison after he pleaded guilty last year to a single count of conspiracy to import cocaine.
So why everybody couldn't be sentenced to 57 months in prison?
No, based on their involvement, the sentences will go. The sentence will go accordingly.
So that 4 years, 9 months.
That's 4 years.
Yeah, almost 5 years.
So yeah. 48.
But we know how jail years go. And
48 and that. No.
It's 5 years.
Yeah, 5 years.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Yeah. But the little man gets sentenced, but the big people are being delayed. Yeah. I wouldn't want delayed. I would want to be sentenced and serve and get back home. Because what's the point?
Exactly, get it out of the way, right?
Because I think Mr. Foy is on house arrest in the U.S., right?
Mm-hmm. So but then you have to look at...
You're still basically in prison?
You have to look at this. Remember the sentencing. You have to take into the sentencing guidelines as well. I assume this is in the U.S. or they should. In the Caribbean, we have sentencing guidelines.
But then again, why is he under house arrest? Why isn't he in prison? Just because he's
because he had, I guess, because of his affiliation being a former.
Well, I don't know that he's under house arrest. If he is, I can't speculate. Yeah, why we have to look at it?
It was in the news.
It was in the news. Did they give a reason?
No, but I'm just saying maybe because he had former political affiliation or him being the governor of the country, you know. It gives him some form of immunity. Just like how Mr. Trump has never spent a day in jail, and I can guarantee you if it was any of the other presidents, including the good president Barack Obama, he would have been on remand and not on any kind of house arrest or given any kind of consideration, although he should have or would have had it.
And I wonder why that is.
Yeah, craziness, huh?
Mm-hmm. Sarcasm on 11.
Oh boy.
Past
10. Wait, but Jamsa, do you realize that is it Mexico that is cutting ties with Ecuador? Those two countries?
Oh yeah, because the Ecuadorian police broke into the Mexican embassy and arrested someone.
They were trying to get the former VP who is facing corruption charges. Mm-hmm. Look at this, a nation against nation, you know.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Boy.
Yeah. But I have a serious problem, you know. This is something you see all over the world, especially around here.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that politicians should be held to a higher standard, meaning you should go to jail at the drop of a hat because you are entrusted with, you're entrusted with public trust, so to speak. I feel that they should be held to a higher standard. And I always have a problem with, leaves a bad taste in my mouth when I look at the fact that these guys do all sorts of crap and they get handled with kid gloves. And I don't like it.
I mean, at the same time, he's awaiting the sentencing. The judge has to go through whatever guidelines they would have. As I said, in the Caribbean, we have sentencing guidelines. So based on whoever you are, there is actually guidelines that the judge would follow to accord the sentence. Of course, you will have the prosecution and the defense counsel both adding to that. You know, there might be some mitigating circumstances and stuff like that. So there's, in the Caribbean at least, there is some guidelines. So regardless of who you are, once your actions match, you will be given a similar sentence.
But you really see how you have two legal systems. I mean, I don't know if you've been following the Donald Trump case.
Somewhat.
You realize anyone else, any regular citizen, probably any other politician would have been in jail a whole bunch of times.
Yep.
Charged. For all the stuff that this guy has done. And he hasn't seen, the guy doesn't even know what the inside of a jail cell looks like. He probably thinks like it looks like a five-star hotel room at this stage because he's never seen the inside of a jail cell. And he's never paid for anything.
From the face of it, and we've heard the arguments being presented. One, he, from what I understand, he's denying his involvement in it. But they are saying, on the other side, that during that time he was inciting, so that they have that against him. In terms too, there is some sort of discussion, legal discussion, as it relates to would he be able to seek office, because I can recall there was some discussion as well as to whether or not he had committed treason
in relation to what happened on in January after during the swearing in process or leading up to that. So there are a number of legal issues. I mean, he's been before the court for so many things, you understand? And
well, anybody else would have been marinating in jail already.
Yeah.
My God.
Yes.
I don't know.
We'll see how it goes.
Marinating or cooked already?
Marinating.
We'll see how it goes.
Both.
Oh, what's your prediction for so far for 2024 presidential election?
No comment.
I think Biden will win.
Mm-hmm. We got a hope.
It's going to be rough. Mm-hmm. We got a hope. I think he'll win.
How it's looking now, and yeah, I will say I will have a comment. This go, it looks like they want Mr. Trump.
Mm.
Yeah, this is like the Easter celebration. Do you want Jesus or do you want Barabbas? Yeah, give us the B man. We don't want the J man. Let's send him down. This is exactly how this is looking at this point.
We have a caller.
Caller, good morning. You're live on Island T. Hello.
Hello, caller.
Hey, good morning. Hey. Morning, guys.
Hey, what's up?
Morning, Journey.
Journey, what's up? Journey, I really want you to actually know, this is a good time. The metaphysical significance of eclipses, I have a feeling that's what you're called about. And I was really sorry I had to cut you off last week because I know there's...
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what I want to talk about this morning is that, you know, I noticed some roadworks was being done of the village between the vicinity of the... primary school, William Connor Primary School, and the laundry.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys know if this is going to be an island thing? Because there are some areas from Bastia going to where I live that I think can have some road work done as well. You know, another road was just resurfaced, but there are some bad works, in my opinion. Coming into Challengers, the first house on the right hand side going towards Old Road. The road is very bad here, and just where the house was burned, there's a little Jane. I think they can get that dig up the same way they did up the village. So I don't know if you guys know if this initiative is going through the whole island main road again. So I just want to hope someone in public work is listening.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you guys have any information on that.
Yeah,
I just want to bring that to the core.
Yeah, and I hope Sophie's listening, so maybe she can address that last week. I mean, sorry, next week. You know, she didn't really talk about any road work. So, but that's a very good point because there must be some technical reason why they're just doing that area, I imagine. You know?
Yeah. All right, that was my concern. Thanks, guys. I'm listening.
Okay, so that's it? You so down to earth today. No.
Yeah, I'm cool. I mean,
no esoteric today. What's going on?
As he's saying after the eclipse, he's gonna have.
You can call during voices. I'm gonna be doing voices, so that's one of the things I'm gonna address. All right. So feel free to call. Okay.
Okay.
Good.
Thank you so much.
I love Journey Spirit.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
So let's see. So. Yeah.
When another thing. Expect Journey to call about.
No, Journey's calling about
high flown matters. He's calling about.
Journey's calling about the road safety, and that's very good. So.
It is a call. Let's take this call.
Okay. 928. Call. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Good morning, guys.
Morning, yeah. Carl.
Morning.
How are you?
I'm not doing too bad for my age.
I know. I love that.
Yes,
and good morning to the listeners from Manabua. Guys, a couple of things.
Yes.
Why is it that St. Peter's ain't had no water since Thursday? Why is it St. Paul's water is being locked off 7 o'clock at night now? And the word on the street, the alleged information is that the water in St. Paul's now is diverted to the big hotel down there.
Mm-hmm.
So at 7 o'clock at night, they are complaining that they don't have any water. When they reach home, they can't bathe nothing. Right? The other thing about water is that two wells were found in Shadwell. Well, you know, the minister had said one had been arsenic on top. And they was working to get off that, and then that water would be usable. The question is, since two wells is found in Shadwell, and Shadwell is so close to St. Peter's, can one of those wells divert to St. Peter's to eliminate St. Peter's water woes under all the governments who come and claim they will fix it, and they do not?
Mm.
The other thing, guys, I am quite surprised that such a big eclipse is happening and we have not heard anything from our officials, how it's going to affect us, if it's going to be big, it's going to be thin, it's going, you know, if we are to get any shade or anything like that, because the last eclipse, lots of shades were sold and given out, and people, you had tons of discussions leading up to it, letting you know the bad and the good, and that sort of thing. Why is it that such a big eclipse is happening and we are not hearing anything from our authorities, how we are to move towards it? What sort of effect, low or high or medium? There is no discussion. All you're hearing, all the foreign media is having discussion on it, but we are not hearing anything here at home. Just some things to think, guys. Are gone.
Thank you, okay. Carl.
Actually, speaking of which, this was something I had intended to mention. There was, we got a notice about, from a listener sent me a notice concerning some water shortages. Let's take a look. Let me see.
I think Kortensia read that too.
Yeah.
Oh, you read it?
Yeah, I read it.
Okay,
it looks like the entire island will be affected when I read it.
Yes.
Or everybody will be affected.
Okay.
And so it's from, as I said, we fill up at 5, so between 5 and 6, but it's Bird Rock, Half Moon, Olivee, Shadwell, Bastyr, Taylor's, Connery Keys, Keon, Otley's, Lodge, Molyneux. You have Phillips's Mansion, Tabernacle, Sadler's, Parsons Grounds, Bay, St. Paul's, Newton Grounds, Sandy Point, St. Peter's, New Road. And it says this will happen. Well, it says it's a water rationing schedule, and it started yesterday, Sunday the 7th, and it goes until Sunday the 14th of April 2024. Hopefully after that, when it comes closer to that, they'll have a next notice as to whether it will stop or if it will continue.
And you know, the situation is dire if you see they're turning water off on weekends, because
and in Bastyr, because we don't normally lose water in Bastyr.
Yes, because my wife mentioned to me last night, she said, and this was like after 7, she said, oh, the water is off. I was like,
So Godwin got half a tree, Conyers, Old Road, Middle Island, Virtuals, Challengers, not in that list.
I haven't seen it, but no. Okay. Look at you calculating where you could go and get a bat. Don't do that.
That was not my calculation.
He could go in Old Road and get a bat.
You said that. Mommy, don't take him back. You said that.
Almost the entire island, right?
So I'm just saying, you know, there's a blessed space
in between there.
A protected space in there.
He just wondering if his room is as
You see, that's why I just said, Mommy, don't take him back.
That's a blessed area that we have to give thanks for.
What in Old Road is... Let me see if anything is there that's connected to Old Road. Shucks, no. Nothing there is connected to Old Road.
But, you know, on a serious note, before we go to the break, it's 9:33. I really would like to see some more speed on getting these desalination plants going up. Yeah. It would be nice, for example, to see them maybe go on a 24-hour basis, getting this thing done as fast as possible. I find sometimes the government takes too long to do things. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I think heaven and earth should have been moved to get these water. To get these water procurement methods off the ground, you know, and it would be nice if we got more information as to what is taking so long.
I was just gonna say, you know? Whether they can come and say, okay, we're short on monies, we need you to do this, we need to do this to raise some more funds. We're trying to, so let us know. So don't let us be out here bashing you or talking bad about you, not knowing what is happening in the background.
Exactly,
because we are not running the show.
Yeah, so don't talk about transparency and then turn around and be not.
We get an eclipse.
I
am just glad that these concerns are being raised and I didn't have to be the only one with them. I am so glad.
Where's the shade? Jackson, can we take the break, please?
Yeah,
can
sure,
we take
sure.
the break?
Fruit. fruta. Fruta full of vitamin. Real fruit juice, not full of vitamin. Pop open the goodness, just dive in. Fruta every night, fruta every morning.
It's the amazing taste and quality in fruit juice you've come to know and love. Anytime, anywhere, any occasion. Fruta is your tastier, better, healthier choice.
We got the vibes, fruta. Real, real nice, fruta.
And for the families, remember to pick up the 1 liter.
Looking for something extra? Look no further. Suppligen's got you covered with our Suppligen Shop and Win promotion. You can be the lucky winner to take home one of three cash prizes. Just spend $12 or more on any Suppligen Tetra products at your favorite supermarket, write your name and contact at the back of your bill, and place it in the specially marked entry form box for a chance to win big. Promotion runs April 1st to May 30th, 2024. Suppligen boosts you up.
That's my girl, Ariana Grande. That's the intro. I love this song. I don't know. I just love this song. What'd you say? Come on, talk to me.
No, I was saying, I was going to say yes and do the action.
Yes and, yeah.
Yes, then.
Uh-huh. So
talking about water, and we have so many people listening from various...
Read some comments. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. So someone said that we hardly have water now, only in the mid-hours to around 6:30 daily. They're saying between midnight to 6 a.m., no water. And this is someone from the Palmetto Point area. Wow. That's Trinity area. So persons are being affected. And there is someone else who indicated 7 p.m. is when restaurants start serving dinner. Some of them are still cooking dinner at this time. Why does the government have to do things the backward way all the time? This is the nonsense that people have to put up with when there is no consultation.
Hmm.
Mm. Oh. Yeah, so those are comments coming in to my phone. Okay. So...
So
we have some calls coming.
We have some calls.
Yeah. Caller, go right ahead.
Yes, good morning, Jamster. Good morning, Azard.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning to the lady in there.
Good morning. Yes.
This problem that we are undergoing presently now is all our fault. Because I've been on this problem here over 10 years ago. I once worked water department.
Mm-hmm.
Once water services. They had a section called pumps. We had our own Julian Wiggins saying, Kate,
mm-hmm.
a lot of things that brought you in, installed, they start to just, after he just start to just disappear, you know.
Yes.
You know, before 1995, we had our own Julian Wiggins, had a man named Jerome Pinney. He went down the Caribbean, you know, teach these people in the Caribbean how to operate these things. How is it now, when he was alive, mainly for what reason, why they put him on long leave or whatever? My head couldn't be resigned. We ain't got sufficient water because when Burdock and all those places were developing, we had to make certain that he put catchment on the top of Burdock Hill and Fiddle and all these kind of things in order for water to reach back down into Bass and go, stay up in Burdock. But for some unknown reason, that same part of water services that refer to as pumps is no longer operational.
Mm-hmm.
That is the whole problem. If politicians the only open their mouth, who can't hear, feel, I wasn't campaigning for no political party. I observed what was going on and I realized I started to talk, but nobody took up the mantle with me to go along to say that let this thing happen. And you are talking about desalination. Desalination ain't gonna work, you know. It cost us too much, you know. We need to get back with Julian Wick. We own. With the two wells down in Shadwell, one is not potable. The other one could be used for farming. I spoke concerning about it long time, long before they start to do the road. But what the one need to do, which is not potable, build a catchment up in Beerfords and send it back down to you for farming. They're doing the road now. I want to see what they're going to do if they're going to implement that idea, because it would be foolish to get a well there and farmers won't be able to use it. because water is not potable. Something the leaders need to understand. Listen to us. We feel in the squeeze. Get out. Mm-hmm. Because water and food go together. Good boy. Thanks.
Thank you so much.
I actually agree. I feel like with how important water is and with escalating rationing, I feel like there should be, we should have like a weekly program telling us about the progress with the wells. And mm-hmm. even, for example, why is that well, why does that well that they talked about have arsenic in it, and explain to us how the arsenic got there and what the process is like? It, I mean, they should have us involved in the process.
I know on Patrick's show as well, there have been various talks as well, and questions being asked as to, you know, they said about the well in Cayenne and really about the water quality. I know a lot of person, especially on his show, he had a couple shows asking questions as he referred to the water quality. So, I mean, before I forget, I want to extend condolences to the family. You know, Shannon Hawley, her dad passed.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, boy. Yeah, condolences. Bobsies,
you know, Michael Hawley, Bobsies, oh. You know, Wings and Things. And so, you know, Shannon being the carnival chairperson and well-known, family well-known too. So condolences, you know. Wow. At this point in time,
Mrs. Yes, Hawley, condolences to you and your family, mm-hmm. Shannon, her brother, her son, everybody, condolences.
Azard, good on you for that, because that was something I had planned to mention. And I, you see how so much, there's things so much stuff sometimes we don't get to, you know?
Yeah, you have it's a list, and sometimes so many things come up, and then you not get to it, and you say, oh, shoot, that was the time to. So sometimes you just have to stop it and just say before you forget.
What you have to say. Yeah, good Wow, so life is so fragile.
Yeah.
So I want to echo what Azad said. Mm-hmm. Going out to Lynn and Lynn, Justin, and Shannon.
Yeah.
My condolences. Yeah. Because these are people I know very well.
Wow.
I mean, I used to play down at Bob Z. Listen, I used to play for Bob Z.
Mm-hmm.
On 4th Street and on Juve and Last Lap, the last 2 days, used to set up in front of Walls.
Yes.
Okay.
He used to have a band, you know, because, you know, his thing used to be in there. So
he
had a band there, and I used to, that used to be fun.
Mm.
It's funny, actually, last year, I was teasingly thinking I should go and tell Bobsy. Bobsy, we need to start, we need to start doing that. Yeah, I didn't realize Bobsy. And Bobsy doesn't look his age.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I had no idea that.
And he kept himself looking well always,
And he's going to be missed.
Yeah.
Definitely.
In fact, when I saw her post it, I was thinking to myself, am I reading correctly?
No,
you know? Yeah, I was wow.
Yeah, that was my reaction. I was
never
what?
I never knew that was happening. Like, he was going through so much pain at the time.
Yeah. We have a call. Call her right ahead.
Good morning, Jamster.
Good morning.
Good morning, Azad.
Good morning,
Kortensia.
Good morning, Mr.
Good morning, Miss Henry.
Good times.
We are well.
Yourself?
How are you?
Oh, yeah, give me thanks. I am telling the nation, start to pray.
Mm-hmm.
You see, maybe we thought, like Azad, and they have the water source down here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, everybody will be suffering, so we better start
don't let AZ fool you. He has a well in his yard in Old Road.
That's a blessing.
That's why he's moving back home.
My God, that's a good economic.
Yes.
See, the prodigal son went and had one lot of carrying on.
The area of the free and rich in history.
You hear that? Boy.
I don't know what to do it now.
Bring it back to earth, Miss Henry. Bring it back to earth.
You give an inch and you take a mile.
Down there, you know.
Yeah?
Even, I think it's that stone where they call the estate there, where they got Caribbean Batique.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Wingfield.
Even during slavery, one of the estate hired people to teach the children, you know.
Mm.
I think his name was Philip or something like that.
Mm. Teach it. Anyway, you mean school? This.
Eh?
You mean like school? Teach them what?
The owner of the estate.
No, you said...
Moravians, remember the Moravians were the better teachers. They were trained, eh?
Yeah, okay.
All right, now come to this eclipse.
Mm-hmm.
Who is responsible for informing the country?
That would be NEMA.
So everybody at NEMA vacation? Now we have a situation where school is out.
Mm-hmm.
Now they would have known, they predicted it. When children were sitting in school, all the school should have assigned a time in which they educate the children.
Yeah.
Many of them will be home on their own because their parents have gone to work.
Mm-hmm. That's as they feel.
If they wanted the glasses, at least they could have gotten them for the primary school then, eh?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, all eyesight is important.
Yeah.
I kept waiting and wondering when. Not a word.
Maybe because we are not going to see it in its entirety. Maybe that's why nothing was said, maybe.
So, that partial
This is partial.
Is not dangerous.
Yeah. Miss handwriting, anything is dangerous when it comes
to So we need to be...
That's what I mean.
It's better to be safe than sorry. Better to be safe
because,
than sorry.
And then they're young. Imagine if it affect the eyes of the youth. What excuse we have? It's negligence, you know? It's pure negligence, and the government is responsible, no matter how you turn it. Because having not heard anything from NEMA, whoever, they should have called them up.
Yeah.
What preparation do you have? So we have children, everybody, any child we want to see, and it's not coming in to almost 4 o'clock. A lot of these children were not alive when we had the last one. What year it was?
Can't even remember.
I was in high school. Maybe, let's say 19...
Yeah, at least a long ago.
97, 98.
That's why I'm saying a lot of these children were not born.
Mm. Yeah, because we have a lot of 2000 babies.
So imagine they hear this eclipse. They want to see.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, who wouldn't want to see?
Mm-hmm.
And then what I'm saying, that the children are home on their own. All of these things should have been taken into consideration because I asked my good friend, what is going on? And even with the water business, what exactly is the reason? Because it's only 1 week, they say.
Mm-hmm.
Have all the things failed? The pumps for the wells? What exactly is the reason?
Hmm.
What will happen at the end of the week?
Yeah. As I mentioned.
You know, we have a situation now where you give a circular answer with no end. We want to know today what is going on, why the whole of the island. Because some places have more access to water, like down in the middle of it. Granted, water comes up.
Mm-hmm.
Are leaking.
Well, Middle Island and Old Road and those places aren't.
Well, the water is pumped back. Since in the 50s,
okay,
they run water lines along the railway to the Bastia register, the reservoir up at Lagreed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we want, and the Prime Minister, he better come and talk. Mm. This habit of not informing our people is not going to work.
Okay.
Sure.
It's not going to work because people are at risk.
Yeah.
Now, if I was a mother, I might have just come home lunchtime and stay home. So that my child, you know, can be safe.
Yeah.
Hopefully parents are listening and parents have been warning their children not to, you know, look up during that time without protection.
Yeah, okay. So, okay. We call. Oh. Someone had said they wanted to call. So.
Okay.
Call. Line is free now. 949. There will be no money matters today. But just letting listeners know that
money
hosting
still matters.
But money still matters.
Yes, of course.
Absolutely.
But Jamsa, before we go on to anything else, though, I saw a report that says high temperatures fuel surge of dengue cases. And if we have the caller, let's go ahead with the caller.
Oh,
line.
No, he hasn't. Okay, here we go.
Up here.
Caller, go right ahead.
Yeah, good morning to everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Good morning.
I agree with Mrs. Henry to everything that she said. And we have to take a stock of ourselves to know exactly what's really going on. Because they've been talking about the eclipse, and nobody is coming forward to let us know exactly what to do to protect our eyes, from getting damaged from this eclipse. When I want to know anything, I just go on Channel 9, and I just tune in, and they give me all the information about the eclipse. If we have to sit back here and find from the government, we will never reach nowhere. So I use my TV to get all my information. And the Prime Minister needs to come back on the radio and explain to the people why are the water shortening still. Because he said the phone well in Cairn, and the people will be in water. And now people is speaking about think he's not having any water. At night in the bathroom, we want to go at 9. So somebody has to come and tell us exactly what's going on. You have a pleasant day.
Thanks so much.
Thank you, caller.
Yes, thank you.
Yep.
And this is what persons are saying, you know, information need to be given to persons. It seems like it's very haphazard. It's like nothing is being said. You just, the country just seem to be on autopilot.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Yeah. I just don't like the fact that, you know, lip service is paid to transparency and so on, and then they do something completely different.
The basic
caller, go ahead. Oh, we have caller. Yes. Caller, go ahead.
Go ahead, caller.
No, man, go and say what you're saying, man. Really.
Yeah, we're saying the basic things that we are to know, they are to tell us, really, and being done well. Go ahead.
Greetings,
now.
Greetings.
Greetings. For all the information shared, you know, for this program. Okay, we want to echo heartfelt condolences to families who are mourning the loss of loved ones, you know, the Harleys and all the other families, you know. We always said that is not a pleasant thing at all. And you compare life and death, the birth of a baby. And people say it's a cycle, it has to happen, but we don't see that. No, we don't. We see life and more life and more life. And we pray that we will get here to embrace, tenaciously embrace life. Life, just life. Kick the capacity, you know? This is what is the name again? This thing, why in the sky? What name again?
The eclipse?
Yes. Okay. If this eclipse is a natural occurrence, why we can't look at it with our naked eyes?
Well, you know, there are a number of things, you know. I could ask you the question, if the sea is naturally there, why can't we just go into it and live?
No, that is not.
Is not that is that not the same thing?
The water, right?
Yeah, going into the sea water, we can't go in there and just, without anything more, just go in there submerged and survive.
Because we are not fishes, we are human.
Yes, but there are things in nature can be dangerous to us if we are not protected. And so to the eclipse.
But we are, we are part and parcel of that same nature. The human species.
Yeah.
So I mean, we just put it on.
Yes, man, no problem. Yes. So we are just urging persons to be cautious, be careful, you know. Due to the information coming and not coming, it's better to be safe than to be sorry.
Okay.
You understand?
So back to I wanna
we have a call.
Okay, go ahead.
Carlo, go right ahead.
Good morning.
Good morning.
With regards to the eclipse of the sun, I think we are making much ado about little with regards to St. Kitts and Nevis.
Yes.
The portion of the sun that will become obstructed when viewed from St. Kitts is less than 5%. It will be barely noticeable. It will be ill-advised for anyone to look at the sun, even with these dark glasses, with the little that will be obstructed from St. Kitts. The fact that it's happening in the United States, you must recognize it's only a section of the United States. The United States is not the world. Eclipses happen multiple times every single year. but they don't affect every part of the world.
Mm-hmm.
And so it will be making a great deal, trying to, at 4 o'clock this afternoon, expecting to go outside and see the place turning back.
No, I don't think that
it
person's...
is less than 5%. And so all this talk Mrs. Henry's making about that the NEMA should be telling us this and telling us that, it is virtually going to go unnoticed in some cases.
Yeah. But you made a mention of the fact that it would be dangerous still to look at, right?
Yes.
And I think that's the point that she's making, that it's not that the place will be darker or will be seeing, you know, less visibility. I think what her point is that during that time, it will be dangerous for us to be looking in the direction of the sun without protective wear. And I think that is what she...
If that is her point, then I consider it, but it is never... It is never safe to look at the sun, even through dark glasses. Mm-hmm. One is, nowadays, people talk about all these dark glasses.
Yeah.
I'm a few weeks older than you guys in the studio. But back in the day, when I had my opportunity to see the first eclipse, which was back in the, late 70s or early 80s, I knew about the time, we were being encouraged to look at it through reflected. Not looking directly at the sun, mm-hmm. but look at it through reflected mirrors shone onto screens in a large space
mm-hmm.
so that we would get the effect rather than us looking at it directly. We would experience it darkening around us,
yes.
and we would see as the moon crossed over in front of the sun, we would appreciate how it looks.
Yes.
But we would not risk looking in the direction of the sun itself.
Mm-hmm.
On the subject of water, let us be fair to the authorities. Miss Henry, all of the pumps haven't gone bad. There is less water on St. Kitts. Full stop. Period. Point. And they are simply trying to get petitions, not just those in the worst affected areas, to conserve water. And one of the ways to conserve water, since we refuse to cut the price of water and make that a factor, make price a constraining factor, is to restrict the hours that we have access to it. My water has been going off after 9 o'clock for over a year. I've never had during Christmas time they allowed water to run 24 hours for a few days. But for the rest of the year, I have no water after 9:30, 10 o'clock at night until after 4 the next morning. Simply extending the hours from 7 to 5, they are trying to impress upon us the severity of the situation. As was pointed out by another caller, contrary to much that is being said, desalination is not going to solve our problem. As a matter of fact, desalination will bring home to us that we are selling water too cheap. Let me preach the sermon I've preached many times. We purchase from the water department a basic residential rate. We pay $20 per month for 2,500 gallons. $18 is for the water. $2 is for the meter. $18 for the water means we are paying $7.50 for 1,000 gallons of water. It means we are paying 75 cents for 100 gallons of water. No one in St. Kitts Nevis can lift 100 gallons of water. A gallon of water is 10 pounds. That's 1,000 pounds. Nobody in St. Kitts can lift up 75 cents worth of water. And yet, we continue to sell water for over 25 years now at the rate of 75 cents for 100 gallons. A tank of water in the fire engine, which holds about 750 gallons, I'm told, or 800 gallons, will cost you less than $10. We are hard-pressed to walk up the street with $10 worth of water in our hands when we buy from the store. But the powers that be, different administrations, have found it politically inconvenient to increase the price of water. One is not trying to say make water more expensive for people. One is saying the cost of producing water, the wages of the workers, the pipes, the diesel to go in their vehicles, all of the costs of generating water, the electricity to pump it out of the ground, have all gone up over the years. Yet we continue to sell water at the same price we were selling it over 20 years ago. If you name me something that was 75 cents 20 years ago that still costs less than a dollar, I'll give you $10. We need to address this subject. A previous elected member of parliament pledged he will never allow the price of water to go up under his watch. That's irresponsible. We cannot do anything about the water. So Mrs. Henry, pray is not going to bring us water. Rain is going to bring us water. It sounds sacrilegious, but that's what the facts are. We need to conserve, and I think the authorities are making an effort to enforce conservation on us by restricting the increased times because there's less water coming down, and therefore our aquifers and other sources, we need to conserve what's in them. May your gentlemen and lady have the finest partial eclipse you've ever had on a Monday in April, and may the rest of the week be wonderful to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Schneid.
Likewise. And on that note, I think we can conclude.
There's a birthday shout out here before we
go.
So hold on, let me get the birthday. Oh, and hi, Candy Franklin. Hi, Candy.
Hi, Candy.
So the birthday shout out is to Horace
Pontine. Hi, human confectionery.
From Carlisle, Paris. So happy birthday, Horace. May you have a wonderful birthday, Mr. Pontine. Blessings and blessings.
Happy birthday. Yes. So guys, I think we can say same time, same place tomorrow.
Yes, and as I said before, the heat is fueling a surge in dengue cases. So please, folks, throw away all the old containers. Keep your space clean and keep yourself away from this particular disease. The death toll is, it's 1,000 deaths that have been reported thus far, and over 3.5 million cases. So please let us be careful.
Well,
so guys.
Okay, but wait. Okay, folks, just letting you know, there's no Money Matters today. Money Matters is brought to you by First Federal, by the way.
But money still matters.
Money still matters, absolutely. And Voices, I'm going to be hosting Voices today. I'm going to be playing that clip. So those of you wondering who haven't heard the interview that Sean Richards did with the news outfit, the Carib Update News outfit in Grenada, we're going to have that this morning on Voices. We'll also discuss the eclipse. I'll try and share some information about the eclipse. And, of course, I'll take your calls on any topic. So I'm hoping that everyone will join me. As many people as possible will join me at 11 o'clock. Maybe even Azad will call in
I'll listen and hear what is going on. Maybe at a different time, you know.
And
at an appropriate time.
I'm also going to discuss that strawpoll.com survey that everyone put out concerning the leadership of PAM. Let people.
Leadership.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Shani is leading at the moment, by the way.
Yes, she is.
Woman power.
Okay. Okay, guys.
So, you know, I want to say something. I want to tell people, you know, go out and go online and vote.
Yeah, strawpoll.com. No space between straw and poll. Strawpoll.com.
And
I should have had higher numbers by now. I think. No, I'm saying it should have had much higher numbers. It's still less than 100, but you know.
Yeah.
It's getting there. Now that you put it out there, it's going to get where it needs to be.
Yeah.
It needs to be.
So see you guys tomorrow.
Same place, same time.
Oh, by the way, we're going to be putting up the cassava. You know, Dominic had...
Dominic lived up to his word. He sent the recipe. So for the young lady that called and said she couldn't find any Kortensia recipes, you can go to our... Is it going to be on our Win Facebook?
Yes,
you can find the cassava muffin recipe.
Yeah, thanks, Shine.
Thank you, Dominic. You did good.
That was a good idea.
Putting it up on the
Facebook. I sent it to a couple of friends of mine who like baking and so on. Yeah, and my friend Nama. Hi, Nama. What's up? Said it to that, but she probably will like that. I'm gonna give that a shot too. I've never cooked cassava, so I'm
should I tell Timothy stay close to the
Timothy?
To the machine? Yes.
Who's Timothy?
To the device.
Huh?
Fireproof.
Oh. True.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I don't mean to show any shade, but
terrible,
I hope you have a.
She's a savage.
So, guys, okay. I think we have overstayed our welcome. And before anyone.
Not really. Oh, go ahead.
Only Jamsa will be taking the punishment
not really.
Today. No money matters, okay, but our voices matter.
Yes.
So.
But and money still matter.
Okay. All right. He's making a real big point about that, isn't he?
He's making sure.
Okay, we go on. It's 5 minutes after 10 o'clock.
It's just how.
Join
just
me for voices
English
at 11.
Is, you know, English is so.